The Tennessee Titans and the Indianapolis Colts play on Thursday Night Football, so we're going to take a minute to go behind enemy lines presented by Microsoft Teams. I'm Amy Wells, and I'm joined by voice of the Indianapolis Colts, Matt Taylor. The Colts are coming off of a hard-fought game against the Baltimore Ravens. Didn't go your way, but man, the Colts looked good for a big portion of that game. Does it seem like a tall task to now turn around and play on Thursday night for this team?
I don't think so, because as you said, the Colts played well for two and a half, three quarters of that game. Really, the third quarter kind of slipped away where the Ravens just kind of imposed their will in that third quarter. They actually outgained the Colts in that period alone, 197-1. The Colts only had four plays on offense in that period, then they turned the ball over. So that's not going to sit well for Indianapolis. I think the Colts on paper are good enough to win games like that. And so to get back quickly to kind of get that taste out of their mouth might be a blessing in disguise.
Where have you seen the biggest areas improvement in this Colts team?
I'm going to say defense. You know, from last year, the defense kind of fell off the cliff. You know, the Colts in 18 and 19 gave up 70% completion percentage to opposing quarterbacks. That was the first time that had ever happened in NFL history. Every layer of the defense needed to be better, needed to be improved. And so the Colts in the offseason, what do? They bring in DeForest Buckner, they bring in Xavier Rhodes, and then more guys continue to develop and grow, like Grover Stewart on the defensive line, Darius Leonard has taken his game to the next level, Bobby Okereke, one of their very versatile linebackers, is really growing in year number two. So Buckner affects every layer of that defense. It obviously helps the secondary not have to cover as long. It pushes the pocket right up the middle into the quarterback. It helps the outside guys get home at defensive end.
Now we've got to talk about another offseason acquisition that seems to be paying off for the Indianapolis Colts, and it's a quarterback that the Titans are all too familiar with in Phillip Rivers. What has he brought to this team, and specifically the offensive side of the ball?
Yeah, he's just brought in experience. He's brought in leadership, and he's brought in, you know, just kind of a calming force in the passing game. And, you know, I don't think there's any secret to the Colts' success so far in terms of wins and losses. You know, they have five wins. Phillip Rivers only has one interception in those five games. He has six interceptions in three losses. So taking care of the football is the big-time onus going into this game.
Now, on Thursday night when the Titans take on the Colts, who are you going to be watching on the field?
Man, that's a really good question. Obviously, I'm going to be anticipating and watching to see if T.Y. Hilton can get back. The Colts are an interesting group this year where they don't have that go-to wide receiver. The Colts are more of a committee, a spread the wealth type offense. 2 weeks ago against the Lions, they had 11 different guys catch a pass. I think on Sunday against the Ravens, that number was 8 or 9. And then obviously, I'll be watching to see how well the Colts can do slowing down Derrick Henry. That's going to be paramount. The Colts have routinely slowed down teams to under 100 yards rushing. If the Colts can do those two things, I think be efficient in the passing game and give themselves a chance to win on first and second down, they might have a good chance to win that game.
Matt Taylor, always so good to talk to you. It's great to see you, my friend. And I can't wait till Thursday night.